Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous desktop paint videos, the focus has always been painting your main color image. This included basics as well as cloning on static images. This video will focus on painting on an alpha channel. You can follow along with this video by downloading the media. You will find the link in the YouTube description or type the link displayed in your internet browser. We are going to use desktop paint to fix an issue and then put it all together in ConnectFX. Let's begin. When working with desktop paint, the alpha channel needs to be a separate clip from the fill image. So in the media library, before you import the files, disable the matte container option in the general tab. Dragging the embedded file into a folder will split the RGB and alpha channels accordingly. Don't forget to re-enable the matte container option for other import tasks. Now switch to the Tools tab. You might need to click on the View column to display the folder's thumbnails in the thumbnail view. Now this alpha channel has an intentional hole cut into it for the purpose of the lesson. However, you will encounter this type of scenario when you're keying a subject who has a color that matches the keyed background. Or perhaps you need to paint an alpha for a logo that has been provided to you. There are other scenarios and multiple ways to tackle the challenges, but we will focus on alpha painting. Since this alpha is a separate clip, there is nothing to stop you from selecting the paint tool, choosing the front option, and just loading up the alpha clip. You can paint directly onto it from here. However, if you exit back to the thumbnail view, the RGB color clip is the context for the alpha clip. This might not always be necessary, but it can help having both in desktop paint. With that said, choose the paint button. Change the mode to use the front and matte option. With the first cursor, click on the fill clip. With the second cursor, click on the alpha clip. Tap anywhere in the thumbnail view to enter into desktop paint. Just reset the paint module and confirm to clear any previous settings. The first image that you see is your fill source. To flick to the alpha, you press and hold the F3 key. When you release the key, it goes back to the fill. You would use this to just flick back and forth between the fill and the alpha. To permanently see the alpha, enable the Show button in the bottom left corner and ensure the matte option is chosen. This shows the alpha overlay on top of the fill. You can scrub through the frames and see the fill and alpha overlay update. If you try and paint now, you will be painting on your fill image and not the alpha. This is just for display. To properly paint on the alpha channel, first turn off the Show option. On the right of the paint interface, you will see the matte options. Turn on the matte button. The overlay returns, but now you are able to paint directly on the alpha. When the matte opacity is set to 100%, you are filling in the alpha. When the matte opacity is set to 0%, you are cutting more holes into the alpha channel. So with a matte opacity of 100%, you can go ahead and paint the alpha on the talent's right eye. Press and hold F3. You will see that you have painted on the alpha channel. Since the subject is moving, you need to paint on every frame to clean up the alpha. In desktop paint, we can speed up this process by using Auto Paint. Switch to the Auto Paint menu. Change the main option from Wipe to User for freehand brush stroking. Advance forward to the second frame that has not been fixed. Now just paint over the right eye again to fill up the alpha. Switch from the record mode to play and the brushstroke is saved. To ensure the same brushstroke is painted on every frame, decrease the paint over time bar to a value of 1. To track the impending brushstroke, click the Animation button. In the Auto Paint options, choose the Stabilizer to enter into the tracking tools. This is an easy track. Go to frame 1 and pick up the tracker box from the middle of the UI and place it onto her right eye. Press Analyze, and the track is done. Exit the stabilizer by pressing Return. To see the tracked animation, enable the wireframe button. When you scrub the time bar, the wireframe is tracked to her face, but the brushstroke has not been painted yet. Go back to frame 1. Press Render to start painting on each frame. Remember that you always go back to frame 1 because the render will start from the current frame you are looking at. The brushstroke has now been applied to every frame and you can now exit Desktop Paint. In the thumbnail view, you now have two clips both ending in a PT extension that is a paint result. To complete the composite, we'll quickly build the rest in ConnectFX. Switch to the timeline view. Select the background clip and press Ctrl+Tab to bring up the effects ribbon. Choose Create ConnectFX to enter into the node compositor. In the media panel on the left, hold Command and multi-select the new paint clips in the folder. Drag and drop them into the ConnectFX schematic. To blend these sources together, hover over the ConnectFX node bin and press B for the Blend and Comp node. Drag the node out of the bin and drop it into the schematic. Connect the Talents fill clip into the first red input. Connect the Talents alpha clip into the first blue matte input. To finish off, connect the background clip into the green background input. And take the output from the Blend and Comp node and connect it to the CFX output node that leads back to the sequence. If you would like to see the same challenge again, but using the ConnectFX Paint instead of Desktop Paint, please click the link now. More desktop videos will be posted soon showing the workflows with Paint. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.